And yet another example of what makes March Madness the greatest and most unpredictable sporting spectacle on the planet, Kentucky's run to the Sweet 16 this season is going to be looked at as a disappointment. Who saw that coming back in January? Who thought that this team had second weekend potential when they were in the midst of the first four-game losing streak of John Calipari's tenure in Lexington? And please, show me who, at that point in time, predicted that Kentucky media would be calling a loss in the Sweet 16, the worst loss in the Calipari era back when there were actual discussions being had over whether or not the Wildcats were going to get into the NCAA tournament. It's amazing how quickly the tide turns in college basketball. Kentucky lost on Thursday night. The 5th-seeded Wildcats fell to the 9th-seeded Wildcats of Kansas State in a game that turned into drama-filled slugfest down the stretch. The final score was 61-58. Kentucky had two shots at the end of regulation to force the Tiger to take the lead. They also gave up an offensive rebound to a 6'3" no-name with 40 seconds left that led to the game-winning bucket. The narrative is going to be that Kentucky choked this game away, that their inability to run offense, and PJ Washington's free throw yips, cost them the final four that seemed a given Thursday morning and a pipe dream on Selection Sunday. The truth is that Kentucky was a flawed basketball team that got hot at the right time before running into a team that executed a game plan to perfection while getting the benefit of a couple of bounces and whistles going their way. And let me be perfectly clear, in no way, shape or form am I saying that Kentucky or Big Blue Nation should be happy with this loss. It should be disappointing. It should hurt, more so for the players than the fans, but whatever. The bracket broke perfectly for them. Everyone in their region was a Cinderella. We weren't wrong in thinking that Coach Cal's kids were the heavy favorites to get San Antonio out of Catlanta. But we need to say that while also acknowledging this, there is a reason that Kentucky was a number 5 seed this season. This was a flawed basketball team. They didn't have enough shooting. Their offense was entirely too predictable, even when they were winning. If Shai Gilgeous-Alexander and Kevin Knox weren't carrying the load for them on that end, they didn't really have anywhere to turn. And on Thursday night, they ran into a team that had the personnel and a game plan to take away Kentucky's two go-to guys. Kansas State is not overly talented, but what they have in abundance are tough, athletic and older guards that are going to put in a shift on the defensive end of the floor. Kentucky fans may not know who Barry Brown is, but I guarantee you that fans of every Big 12 team can tell you just how good he can be. I guarantee that coaches in the Big 12 can tell you just how annoying their guards are, and those little guards played that role to perfection. To put it another way, it wasn't a fluke that Gilgeous-Alexander struggled to make plays off the dribble the way he has for the last 2 months of the season. It wasn't an accident that Kevin Knox struggled to find a way to get the looks he had become accustomed to getting coming off of Kentucky's circle sets. And in a 40-minute basketball game, when one team matches up well with another, something as simple as Xavier Sneed catching fire and Washington going 8-for-20 from the foul line will get you beat. But that's neither here nor there. Because the real point that I am trying to make here is that this particular Kentucky team just wasn't all that good. They had their flaws masked by the improvement of a couple of kids who played out of their minds for long stretches of the season, and I just don't think that's something that should be overlooked. Maybe this is just my mindset as a fan. I enjoy the ride more than I need to celebrate the ending. Give me a reason to tune in every game. Make me excited to have the monotony of a week broken up when the ball tips. I'm good, and I think this Kentucky team accomplished just that. But 2 weeks ago, no one thought this team had a shot of getting to the Elite Eight. 2 months ago, every Kentucky fan would have taken a trip to the second weekend in a heartbeat. The ending sucked, no doubt about it. But this team kept fighting on, kept improving and, in the end, lost because someone took makeup remover to the cosmetics that Calipari applied. Be disappointed, but don't lose sight of the big picture. Omaha, NEB, Kansas is vulnerable, exploitable and limited. The Jayhawks have no depth, are without a superstar and possess a middling defense. They are Bill Self's worst team. And they have won the Big 12 regular season and tournament titles, secured a 1 seed in the NCAA tournament and are a win away from the Final Four. The Jayhawks shrugged off some late sluggishness to dispatch No. 5 Clemson 80-76 on Friday night in the Midwest Regional Semi.